Hello everyone, welcome to this tutorial. Here we are going to discuss about how to apply a Indian passport by Tatkal service and receive the passport within 15 to 20 days. This has been applied by some of my friends and my relatives as well, and we are able to receive the passport within 15 to 20 days. So this is really a good service and a good improvement in service by Indian government through Indian passport. So here we are going to cover all the step-by-step process right from applying your passport online till you receive your passport. So first thing that we are going to cover here, the documents that we require for the application. So the first document is 1 year bank statement. I suggest you should take more than 1 year bank statement. So you take a print of the bank statement that you receive online and get it sealed through the bank, or you can go to the bank and get an original statement that you can receive from there. And next thing is that passbook of the existing bank account, and next thing is a letter from the bank in the bank letterhead. So I have attached the format of the bank letterhead just below. You can check the links here. And then your PAN card, then your voter ID, then your 10th certificate, annexer F and annexer I, and a marriage certificate or the marriage affidavit. If you want your spouse name to be printed on your passport, so please get it done as well. The marriage certificate or the marriage affidavit you need to submit along with the documents. So next thing is to see where is the passport office and what is the fee I need to pay for my passport. So all these things are very neatly described on the website. So the passport website is www.passportindia.gov.in. So you can see, as it is flashing, Aadhaar letter or card is now acceptable as a proof of identity and proof of address for passport application form. So if you have a Aadhaar card also, you can produce instead of your bank statement and all. So that's also is considered. So now let's come to the point that what is the fee? How much do I need to pay? So there is a link here on the left side, fee calculator. So you go there, you choose, I want a passport, I want an online passport, this passport is a fresh application for me, and what is the age? I'm more than 18 years old. Number of pages I want is 36 page, and scheme is Tatkal. So then the calculate fee. So this is 3500 is my fee. So this amount you can carry to the passport office. They collect the cash from there and they will give you a receipt. And the next thing is that different kind of annexures that we just discussed, annexer I and annexer F. So here is the link for that. Here annexer I and affidavit are present here. If you click on this link, there are multiple documents are being present which can be downloaded and used for your purpose. And then to locate the PSK, which is Passport Seva Kendra. Where is the PSK? Let's say you are in Bangalore, and where is the PSK? So click on this link, locate Passport Seva Kendra, and find your city Bangalore. Say go, and you find the different PSKs present in different locations. So whichever PSK is nearer to you, or wherever you can get an appointment, you can go to the same PSK. Now let's get started with the registration process. You can go to home, and here you have a link to register as you are a new user. Click on register. Then after this, it will display you a form. So here you need to choose the passport office where you belong to, let's say from Bangalore, and give your full name here and your surname here, your date of birth, your email ID. Email ID is a must you should give so that you can receive all the information through your email ID. Then if you want your email ID to same as your login ID, which is preferable, choose yes here. So your email ID will be written as part of your login ID. Then choose a password, then give the confirmed password, choose a hint question. In case you forgot your ID or password, then you can retrieve through this. Give your answer, enter all this text whatever written here, and say register. Once you do this, one email will be triggered to the email address that you have given here. So log into your email ID. There will be a link to activate your account. Click on that link and your account gets activated. Once your account gets activated, we need to fill some more details before applying it. That we'll see in the next section. Hello everyone. So in the last tutorial, we saw that how to register with the website and how to find out the fees and how to find out the annexure and affidavits required. Now we'll just log into our account and start filling up the form for actually applying for the passport. So here you can see that there is a login button. You can just click login here. And then the user ID, whatever you have used, that is your email ID. You can give your email ID, whatever you have used during the registration. Say continue. Then you have to fill the password here and the character, whatever you can see here, the same thing you have to fill in this blue box. So once you fill it and click on login, so you land to this page where you can see that we have a link at the top, apply for the fresh passport or reuse of the passport. So click on this link. Once you click on this link, you have multiple options here, like you can download the soft copy of the form and fill it offline and then upload it back. So this is one option. Other option is you can fill the form online. I would prefer to fill the form online. So click on this option. So now what you are applying for, you need to choose. So we are applying for fresh passport, we are applying for Tatkal passport, and we want 36 pages. And this detail has to be formed in case we are applying a passport for a minor. So now I will not fill this because we are not applying for a minor. Click on next. So you land into this page. In this page, you have to fill all the information which have been asked for. And please fill in all the correct information as per your address and as per your documents that you are going to submit, because it has to be verified against your document and police verification will also happen. So please fill in all the correct details here. So whatever details have been asked, you can fill all the details here. So I will show you one of the form that I have already filled and saved. This is the application I have filled. I have filled the name, the surname, and all other details that I need to fill. I have filled almost everything here. Go to next. You have to fill your father's name, and if you're married, you need to fill your this. The here in this place, the spouse name will come. You need to fill that. Go next. Here you need to put your the address where you are residing from the next from the beginning, your address and your phone number, your email ID, everything you need to fill. Then you have to fill the emergency contact number. You can see that I have actually filled some dummy data and some of the fields I have kept it blank, but please do not do that. You have to fill all the correct informations and all the proper data. Even if the fields are not mandatory, still you try to fill it, like mobile number, telephone number, email ID, everything you fill. Then I can click on next. And as I proceed, you can see on this, that on this side, left side, you can see that actually I am completing this. So it's becoming blue, and this is the dark blue where I'm at this current point of time what I'm filling. So all these things you have to fill. You have to fill this reference addresses. This reference addresses should be somebody in your place residing near to your area. So I would say that whatever the pin code you are giving, so whosoever pin code is same, you can give their reference. So and next thing, that if you have a passport, you need to fill it. I don't have a passport before, need not to fill. You can keep it blank. Then some other details. Read through all these questions and answer appropriately. For me, it all, everything seems as no, so you can fill it as it is applicable to you. Then go to the next session. Here you need to fill the place name, you need to date, it automatically takes, and you can click on this I agree. So it will say that first save your application, then only you can do a preview. So I can say save my details. Now I will stay do a preview. So if you do a preview, you can see all your fields whatever you have filled has come here. So you can just see that whatever field are correct or not. Then you can do a close, go back here. Then till now we have not submitted our application. Now I want to submit my application. So click on I agree. Before no, I don't want to share my contact. And then I would say submit the form. So now my form is being submitted. To book the appointment, First thing is that when you go into your account, then you will see that there are view saved or submitted application. Click on this. Once you click on this, you can see your application reference number here, and whatever the name you have applied with, that name will be displayed here and date will be displayed here. So check on this button. Then you are interested in manage appointment, so click on manage appointment. Once you click on this, you and here also you can clearly see that it is written you have not taken an appointment. So you take an appointment here in normal or tatkal quota. You take tatkal, then create appointment. You can put whatever the PSK location you want, and then put this number here and do a show available slots. So once you do the show available slots, it will show you the available slots within which you can go and meet the officers in the PSK. So right now if I click on this, you cannot see any appointment slot because these appointment slots are very filled very fast. So for the tatkal, I think the appointment slots open 3 p.m. of the previous day. That means, let's say for tomorrow, today 3 p.m. the tatkal slot would have opened. And similarly, for normal quota also, there are some timings of tatkal. There are some timings when the slots will open. So just Google, you will find the timings of each PSK when the slots will open. So be in front of the computer during that time so that you can book the slots. So the difficult part is to book the slot. So you need to be careful and be on time in front of the system so that you can book a slot. So once you have booked a slot, then again go back to view and submitted application form. You go here, choose this button and click on print application receipt. Once you click on this, you can see that whatever the application you have submitted, whole of the receipt have been displayed. And once you take that appointment details also will be displayed here. The passport seva kendra, the date of appointment, the appointment ID and the reporting time, everything will be displayed. You can take the print of this along with all other documents when you are going to the passport seva kendra. So just remember that we have discussed all the documents that need to be taken along with this application form. So before you are visiting the passport seva kendra, make sure that all the documents that you need to submit are there with you. The original copies, the original documents are there. Along with that, you should have the photocopies, at least two set of photocopies you should carry always. So let's recap the documents that we need. So first thing is 1 year bank statement. You need to get the bank statement along with the seal of the bank, and preferably more than 1 year bank statement with all the transactions till date. Then the passbook of the existing bank account, original plus two photocopies, letter from the bank in the bank's letterhead with a stamp and a signature. This is also required as original and photocopies. Similarly, PAN card, voter ID, 10th certificate, annexer F, annexer I, marriage certificate or marriage affidavit. All these things are required in original along with the photocopy. So the most important part for tatkal application is annexer F. So annexer is the most important document, that if you have that document, then you are through with the tatkal application. So let's look at this annexures, how this annexures looks like and what need to be filled there. So here on the home page of Passport Seva, you can see on the left hand side, there is a column called annexure and affidavit. So click on that annexure and affidavit. So now you can see that all the possible annexures are here. So we are bothered about annexer F and annexer I. So here, verification certificate for tatkal passport, that is annexer F. Click on that. You can see that there is an annexure certificate. So you need to take this printout of this page. Anyway, wherever you get the certificate, they will have their own format already available, but that format should match with this format. There might be little bit here and there, but mostly the format should match. For just a cross verification, you can take this annexure F. And this annexure F, the most difficult part is this annexure F has to be filled by some government official with a very high rank, having credibility, so that can be trusted irrespective of the police verification. Because in tatkal applications, the police verification happens after the passport is being issued. So that is why it's a difficult part. Here you have a list of people who can actually prepare this certificate for you. So this part you need to follow up with your respective government officials from where you can prepare the passport. There are multiple options are there, so you can go through any of this option and you can prepare that. For Annexure I is a standard affidavit actually. So if you look at this, this is a self affidavit. You can go to any notary who prepares the affidavit and prepare this affidavit there. So these are two things that you need to done. From my point of view, Annexure F is the most difficult part for a Tatkal passport. So get the Annexure F, then you are all set for a Tatkal passport. So get all these documents and visit the passport seva kendra, the time which is given to you, the appointment date and the time. So now I will show you a video which is by a passport seva kendra, so that you have a look and feel of how passport seva kendra is and what is the procedure once you go there. So just stay tuned for the video.
On the appointed day, he reaches the passport seva kendra, where he is guided through the application process up to granting in 7 easy steps. Starting with a thorough security check, he enters the pre-processing area. At the pre-processing area, his appointment slip and documents are checked by the staff and a token is issued. He proceeds to a comfortable waiting lounge. Here, he can enjoy several facilities while waiting for his token number to appear on one of the electronic displays. When his token number is displayed, Rahul proceeds to the stage 1 processing counter. At this counter, Rahul's demographic data is verified by citizen service executives. This counter is also equipped for document scanning, biometric scanning, photography, and collecting the passport application fee. He next proceeds to the application verification zone. Here, officials from the passport office verify his documents for authenticity and completeness. Once the verification process is completed, he is guided to the waiting area of the granting zone. When his token number appears on the display, he meets the granting officer, who checks his application in the system for duplicity and other background information, and then takes a decision on granting of the passport to Rahul. Finally, he receives a letter confirming his passport approval at the exit counter. In just 7 steps, Rahul has completed the requisite formalities at the Passport Seva Kendra. His passport will now be dispatched in a few days once the police verification process has been completed.
Hello everyone, now I guess you all are clear on how to apply for a passport and what to be done on the passport seva kendra. The videos are quite clear. So now you have applied for the passport, you came back to your home. Next thing is that when should I get the passport? So tracking your application. So how to track the application? On the home page, you can see on the left side there is a link, track application status. Click on that link, give your file number here and give your date of birth here, then you can click on this link track. So once you do that, it will display your file number, your name, your date of birth, when you applied for the passport and the current status, something like it has gone for police verification. I'm not talking about Tatkal, talking about a general case. For your Tatkal application, I think the status will be that pending for printing or something, it will be there. And as soon as it is being sent to you, the status will be updated online also, a message will be sent to your mobile and a email will be sent to your email address. So all kind of communication happens from the passport seva kendra so that you don't miss your passport. And the passport is being sent through the speed post and it will be delivered to you at your home. It at max take 1 or 2 days to get delivered. So your status will be updated with the tracking ID of the speed post so that you can track the speed post also. So that's all about the tracking status. So one more thing after that, if you are not satisfied with the service or you have already given the passport for a long time and you are not getting out the passport, what you should do? So see here, you have an option of contact us. Below this, there is a service called visa services. There is a service called passport. Under that, you have a feedback. Go to feedback. And here it says that if you have some suggestion, you can give some suggestion. And grievance, you have some grievance, you can put a grievance also. So you can click here to register your grievance. Fill your file number here. So you can fill your application reference number, file number, passport number. And if you don't have any reference also, you can fill. But it is always better you should fill the application reference number, because you have the application but you don't have the passport now. So fill that number here. And here the passport kendra, which passport kendra you applied for, and all other required informations you need to fill here. You need to describe your grievance here within 3000 words. Fill this and submit the application. Once you submit this, you will get one reference number. So you actually can track your reference number also. If you go to this passport again and then to the feedback, that is this. Link that to view the status of your registered grievance, click here. You click here, give the service request number, the file number and the date of birth and say search. It will find you what happened to your grievance and what is the response to that. So I have actually applied for this grievance and got a response also. So this is a very good system we have for this. So this is all about your passport application. Hope you guys now understood how to apply for the passport and how to get it done. One last thing is that you can contact the service center also, the call center that they have, and to get all the information what you require, or if some information is displays on the status and you are not able to understand that, you can call them up. So the number is, you can go to contact us, say passport and say general information. So this is actually the toll free number, which is 1-800-258-1800. So you can see what is the timing. Timing is 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. People are available who can respond to your queries. Otherwise, it is an automated system available 24/7. So that's all. I guess I have given you all the info. So this will really help you in applying the passport. Thank you.